So, 30 years since Cory started its historic hat-trick at the Royal Albert Hall, 3 years in a row winning the national title. And I'm with Gwyn Thomas, the band's legendary soprano player. You were with the band for the hat-trick and the other Nationals win in 74. In fact, you were a long-standing player with the band.
That's correct, Phil, yes, yes. It all started back in 1956, I started with the band.
Well, of course, a lot of the band's competitive success came when Major Kenny came through the door, didn't he?
Oh, yes, yeah. I mean, he was a real magician.
So what are your memories of him in rehearsal? What was that magic ingredient that he brought to the band?
I honestly think it was because he gave soloists, or the end players as we know them, the end chairmen, he gave you a lot of leeway. He always allowed you to do what you wanted to do. And if he found it wrong, then he'd stop you. But it was so often he'd give you so much license in a slow melody, especially in slow melody, in test pieces, you did your own thing. And more often than not, it worked.
Something really clicked between the Major and the Cory band, didn't it?
Oh yes, because if you look man for man around the stand, we didn't have by any stretch, other than I've got to make the exception of Jimmy, we weren't all fabulous stand-up soloists at the time. But as a unit, as a complete unit, it clicked and it worked, you know, and that's the great thing about it.
One of a very select few bands to have done a national hat-trick.
At that time, yes, because there was only Blackdyke Mills and Fordens were the only two bands that won the hat-trick then. Yeah. I mean, following on from that, I mean, Desmond did it then after that.
That's right.
But at the time, we were the third band ever to have done it. So, yes, it was something really special. That was my thing, was that the hat-trick. It has to be the thing that stands out for me was within that third time. That was really special. Yes.
So the 1982, the test piece was contest music.
Yeah, well, really, yeah.
First time it was used as a contest piece?
As a contest piece, yes. It had been played prior to the national championships, but not as a test piece. And very difficult piece. Second movement especially, the chord in there, and the subdued playing at the end of that was something special.
And very wide open, wasn't it?
Very, very much so. And I remember going into your Blackdyke and it was really, really close. And then Peter Parks, for the last sort of 20 to 24 bars, he seemed to lose it completely. What happened, I don't know. But the band crossed terribly and the rhythms went all to hell. And I think that's how they lost it, to be honest. And
you snuck in. Wow.
And that was it, yeah. I mean, and then, well, as you know, in the second one on Ballet for Band, I mean, I personally missed out a complete bar in the last movement.
It's got a great soprano part, Ballet for Band, hasn't it? And it's beautiful, sweet, lyrical,
lovely
solos, just up your street.
It was.
And then, yes, anyone who's listened to the recording will hear the missing link. Talk us through that.
As you can imagine, yeah, I completely and utterly miscounted, and I did apologise as we were walking off the stage for the major. As I said, I played the first and the last entry, but the middle one, I must have either fallen asleep or just completely lost the plot. But at the end of the day, it worked out fine. And then, of course, the last one of all dances and arias was something really special. Well, you could hear a pin drop, and you know the adage of being in the Albert Hall with people with the scores. You could just hear the flick of the pages or see anything, and it just went without a hitch. Even I played every entry that day.
Well done.
And it worked. And come the end, I mean, the place erupted, and we just had the feeling we'd done it. You know, we cracked it.
That was certainly a great performance, and I loved the closing moments of the performance. And what did the Major think of it all?
I saw him through a sort of a haze for the rest of the evening. I think it was, if you can say that. But yes, after all, he was absolutely the moon before. Like I said, he was the best.
Thank you very much indeed, Gwyn Thomas, legendary soprano player, Cory Bands.